Hi, we are Team R3 from Ryerson University in Toronto, Canada. Welcome to our 2022 System Acceptance Review. Our diverse team of engineering, arts, business, and architecture students have been working diligently to develop our Mars rover. Despite the challenges faced by COVID-19, we have successfully recruited and trained new members and continued our work all in a virtual environment.
Our sheet metal chassis is designed to be strong and durable while being optimized for weight. For cooling, the chassis has large ventilation openings and can be covered with a heat-reflective Mylar composite top. The wheels use BLDC motors with closed-loop drivers to improve overall speed control. This improves both precise and large-scale movements. New motor mounts were also made to reduce weight while maintaining strength. Our wheel design is optimized for shock absorption and stability. The PETG hub has a slight flex, and the polyurethane treads are able to conform to the terrain for a smoother ride. In addition, our double lambda rocker bogey suspension ensures that the rover can traverse over any kind of terrain, smooth or rough. The frame is manufactured from carbon fiber tubing and aluminum linkages, which provide a high strength to weight ratio. To fit the new 1.2 meter cube deployment size requirement, the rover's primary Z-axis was shortened. To compensate for this, the secondary tube was lengthened, allowing the end effector heights to be adjusted between tasks. There are two end effectors on the rover, a rotary tool on a linear rail and a two-clawed gripper. Each specializes in tasks such as interacting with buttons, switches, drawers, or payloads.
A standard gamepad controller is used for intuitive control of the rover, for both drive and arm manipulation. In addition, the rover utilizes numerous cameras and sensors, which are streamed to the driver via 900 MHz and 2.4 GHz bands. This information is displayed on the GUI, which can stream multiple camera feeds simultaneously, along with rover speed and the compass bearing to aid the driver in navigation. For the autonomous navigation task, a GPS is used in conjunction with the compass to create a vector between the rover's current position and the desired destination. As the rover traverses towards a post, the PID controller is used to perform corrections when deviations occur. In addition, our OpenCV-based image detection algorithm is used to quickly detect the AR tags when the post is within range. An LCD display is used to monitor aspects of the rover such as current voltage values and mode of the rover, including driver mode or autonomous navigation. The rover has also been outfitted with an e-stop button, which can be used in case control is lost. The hardware team's focus was redesigning the control system to be modular and increase troubleshooting efficiency. The new power distribution board was designed from the ground up with custom buck and boost converters to improve the overall power consumption of the rover, including overcurrent and voltage protection for all its components. These converters are arranged to be easily interchanged or replaced.
For soil analysis, a single life detection protocol is used to detect the presence of DNA, proteins, and lipids. Soil is collected using an auger and transferred to test tubes housed in an indexable carousel where they are then centrifuged. Cross-contamination prevention was a key design focus, so each specimen has a separate set of augers, test tubes, and syringes. A hemotoxilin solution is used to detect DNA, staining purple-blue, and is analyzed using a spectrophotometer probe at 450 nanometers. A burette reagent is used for detecting proteins, staining mauve, and a Nile blue solution is used for detecting lipids, staining blue. Both are analyzed with the probe at 540 nanometers. The presence of these macromolecules, or lack thereof, indicates whether life, extant life, or no life is present. Since our process has been proven successful in a lab environment, a similar spectrophotometer is being implemented on rover. Environmental conditions are measured using an anemometer and a DHT22 temperature and humidity sensor. For geological analysis, a camera and microscope are used to observe rock and fossil specimens, which are then identified by comparison with a searchable database.
We believe our rover is ready to compete in URC 2022 and would like to thank our sponsors for all of their support and our team members for all of their hard work.